Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. On this video, we do order of operations on problems with decimals in which there is only addition, subtraction, and multiplication, and we do the following problems. All right, you already need to know how to add, subtract, and multiply with decimals. And now we're going to do some problems that have both in the same problem, so we'll need to use the order of operations. So here's an example. So what do we do first in the order of operations? We do anything inside parentheses. So this is the 7.3 minus 6.2. So you can go over to the side to figure that out. And remember, we need to line up decimal points. So that is 1.1. So this then is 5.2 times 1.1. All right. Now, when you have a number next to parentheses, it means we're going to multiply. Now, remember how to multiply with decimals? You just need to do 52 times 11. I've done a video on how to multiply by 11 the easy way, or you could go ahead and go off to the side and multiply 52 times 11. To get 572. So in any case, we do 52 times 11 is 572, but then we note that we have one place after the decimal point and another digit after the decimal point. We need to our final answer has to have two digits after the decimal point, so we have to put it right here. So that is our answer for this problem. All right, so here's one for you to try. So put the video on pause and try this on your own. All right, so again, our first step will be to simplify within the parentheses, and there's a subtraction. There could be an addition or a subtraction in there, right? There just happened to be a subtraction again. So I can go over to the side, make sure you line up decimals, and this is 1.22. So I have 2.4 times 1.22. So we're going to have to multiply 24 times 122. All right, you can do that any way you want. I have videos on how to multiply using different methods, or you could do a traditional method, etc. But in any case, you need to multiply 24 times 122. And hopefully you got that's 2,928. All right, now we have to decide where to put the decimal point. And notice we have one digit after the decimal point here and two more places, so we need a total of three places after the decimal point. So our answer is 2.928. So here's our next problem. Again, we need to use order of operations. So the first thing in order of operations is to add what's inside parentheses. So your first step is to add the 2.01 and the 1.02, and that'll give us 3.03. So we want to copy everything up into that point. And in parentheses, that is now 3.03. Now we've got to be careful here. A common mistake in order of operations is to think you can just add this 4.06 plus 0.3, but that is not the case. This is multiplication right here, this 0.3 times 3.03, so we need to multiply that before we do any addition over here. So I need to keep writing the 4.06 plus, and now I need to multiply these two numbers together, which is 3 times 303. Okay, you could do that on the side or any way you want. You're going to get that's 909, but then you have to decide where to put the decimal point. So look at the places after the decimal point. You've got one digit here, two digits there, so it's going to have to go in three places, so it's 0.909. And now we can add these two together. So you have to line up the decimal point. And that gives you 4.969. Right, here's one for you. So put the video on pause and try this on your own first. All right, once again, we've got parentheses. We need to do that first. So you could do that on the side if you need to. We're going to just line up the decimal points, and that gives you 5.13. So we have 5.08 minus 0.2 times 5.13. Okay. And then again, we're going to have to do this multiplication before I do the subtraction from the 5.08. So I still have the 5.08 minus. All right, so we've got to do 0.2 times 5.13. So we just multiply 2 times 513. Any way you want, you're going to get 1026. And then we have to decide where the decimal point goes. We've got one digit after the decimal point there, two digits for that one. So we have to have three digits after the decimal point for our answer. And now we can do our subtraction. So be careful when you subtract. Remember, you're going to have to line up decimal points. So we have 5.08, and we've got 1.026. And remember, you need to put a zero up here. You need to have the same number of digits after the decimal point for your subtraction here. And so now you go ahead and do this subtraction, and your decimal point will be right here. So let's see, if I borrow, just do regular old-fashioned subtraction, we've got 4.054. All right, here's our next problem. See if you could figure this out on your own by putting the video on pause. All right, so we have two things in parentheses, and since these parentheses in the middle are next to each other, it's the final thing will be a multiplication. But we need to first simplify within parentheses. So we have to do 3.1 times 1.2, and when you line up the decimals there, you're going to get 4.3. And then we have to do 3.4 minus 1.3. When you line up the decimals there, you're going to get 2.1. So now we have a multiplication, 4.3 times 2.1. So you multiply 43 times 21, whatever method you want, and you should get 903. Okay, and then we have to decide where to put the decimal point. So we have one place after the decimal, another place after the decimal, so our answer has to have two places total. So that's our answer for this one. So I hope you got 9.03. I'm not doing the 43 times 21. You just have to go out to the side and do 43 times 21, or you could use the lattice method or any other method for multiplication. All right, here's a problem involving squaring something. So in this case, that's our first step, because we do have parentheses, but there's just a number. There's nothing to simplify inside this parentheses. So the next thing would be doing anything to do with exponents. So we need to square 1.2. So remember, that means 1.2 times 1.2. So think, what's 12 times 12? That's 144. And then you need to move the decimal in two places, because there's a place in each of these after the decimal point. So 1.2 squared then is 1.44. All right, what's the next step? Well, we have a multiplication here. The 1.1 times 1.44, that comes before this addition. So I copy the 4.35. And now we have to do 11 times 144. So you could do that any method you want. And that is 1584. That's 11 times 144. And then you have to move in the decimal point, the appropriate number of places. You've got 1, 2, 3 places you're going to have to move it in. And so then we just line up the decimal points and add. 5.934. All right, let's try this one. So I have to simplify inside parentheses first before I do my squaring, right? Always, if there's something to do with inside parentheses, we do that first. So I've got to do 5 minus 4.8. And again, remember to put this 0 up there before you subtract. So that'll give you a 0.2. So we have 40 times 0.2 squared. Oh, hopefully you tried this on your own first. If not, put the video on pause and see if you could finish on your own. Next step, I've got a square. Remember, don't multiply the 40 times 0.2. We're going to square the 0.2. So to square 0.2, that's really just 2 times 2, which is 4, right? But remember, if you're multiplying 0.2 times 0.2, you're going to have to move the decimal in two places. So we're going to have 0.04. And now we've got 40 times 0.04. That means an easy way to do this is think of it as 40 times 4, right, which is 160, right? And then you're going to move the decimal in two places for right here. So our final answer is 1.6. For you fraction lovers, you could have done 40 times 0.04 using fractions as well. So 0.04 means 4 hundredths, right? So it means you're multiplying times 4 hundredths. And then if you cancel, divide top and bottom by 10, you really have 4 times 4 over 10. Notice that gives you 16 tenths. And 16 divided by 10, just move the decimal in one place. So you're going to get the same answer. I'm not suggesting you should change it to fractions, but you know what? If you do, you will end up with the same answer if you, in the end, write it back as a decimal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.